And welcome back. He's scratching his head here with Garrus and Caden and me, and there doesn't seem to be a way to go to the CSEC Academy from the rapid transit. Oh, I'm going to Citadel Tower. Embassies, consort chambers, financial district, wards we've all been to. Yeah. Maybe because we haven't been there yet? Now we gotta go from. Well, what's closest? Alright, let's get out of here then, because this is a. So let's go back to where you were. We were at the embassies. The CSEC HQ, that we want. Why? I must be clicking on something. See, I'm trying to drag. I'm not sure. Sorry, guys. You're probably screaming at your monitors or your tablets, what have you. Your screens of your mobile devices. Well, let's head over to the financial district. And. Maybe she can tell us. At some point I could see it on the map.
Welcome to Presidium Tourism Terminal 3. The statue you see before. In the aftermath of the Krogan rebellions, several embassies petitioned to have the statue removed. However, this motion was eventually.
That's all for now.
Yeah,
thank
yeah.
Thank you for using Avena.
Uh-huh.
Have a pleasant day.
We'll cut you right off here. CSEC Academy. Oh, we gotta go to Cora's den also. we get this one? Why are we loading? Does that mean anything? Oh, 2C-Sec Academy, this way. Alright. That's where we're gonna go. I did not notice that. Obviously. I guess we've never been over this bridge. That's directions. What's it say? The embassies are located at the end of this bridge just to the right. Continue past the embassies and down the ramp to find the elevator down to C-Sec Academy. Are you kidding me? Back where I was? Past the embassies and elevator down? I didn't mean to. Can I get rid of that? Thank you. I don't think I've actually been along this particular bridge, actually. But it is bringing me back to where I was. So it's in here? What? Can I ask her about it?
Welcome to Presidium Tourism. On the far end of this level, you can see the Citadel Tower, where the Council meets regularly to discuss matters of interstellar importance.
I want to know more about Citadel Security.
Citadel Security serves as law. Executor Palin, a Turian, is the current head of CSEC. But individually, if you wish to learn more, Executor Palin's office is located in the CSEC headquarters just across the lobby.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, and thank you for using Avena. Please enjoy your visit to the Citadel.
Yeah. Where's these elevators? Continue past. Past the embassy. Okay, so it's not this way. Oh, it's not that way. Things are a lot better now that I've remapped my, action key. Well, I changed my action key. I remapped the whatever squad I had. I think I had, rally set to delete and action to delete. So... I don't understand. Where can I find this? I'm sorry, guys. To C-Sec Academy this way. I feel like I'm being led in circles, literally. Oh, this? This? Okay. Oh, good. Is there any bug over here? I think there was one over here. I just want to get them all. You know? Alright, maybe not. What are you doing, Caden? Jumping all over the seats, crazy thing. I'm actually moving faster. I think a tiny bit. Finally, guys! The Academy!
In light of the recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply. Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
No protection for you. Death bring death. And Saren McLaren is coming. I thought they were playing, I thought they were playing Feliz Navidad for a second. Okay. More elevators. Terrain with gun. Here's Wrex. I didn't even press that.
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
Cool. I don't take orders from you.
This is your only warning, Wrex.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
Nice. Awesome.
Go on. Get out of here.
Do I know you, human?
You will.
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
Or my name's Shepard.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you. We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Want some help?
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying. Seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
Those humans have a very similar saying. I like that saying.
I think we're gonna get along just fine, Wrex.
Ha.
Let's go. I hate to keep Fist waiting.
Who's... Oh, that's, what's her name? I can only take two people. Oh, wait, who is this? And who's that? I thought this was Ashley, but Ashley's here. So... So he is good in combat and biotic. Ashley's just completely awesome in all combat, sucks in everything else. We are good in biotic and combat, like Wrex. I do want to bring him with us, though. So we need someone good with tech strength as well, though. That's... We need someone having something like that. Caden. I guess that's why I have Caden along. Caden's the only one who's got some tech. Well, and Garrus, never mind. I do want to bring Wrex. If we bring Wrex, he's the same as us. Wrex and Garrus. Aliens for the win. Cool. We're gonna kick some butt. We'll get our butt kicked. One of the two. Some rapid transit. I just wanna look around in here. I know it's stupid out there saying, let's go, Wrex, and then just walking around the academy. Oh. Cool. Hello.
One sec, hooking you up.
Huh, great.
Commander Shepard, here with the Alliance military. First time on the Citadel, that about right?
Sure is.
How did you know all that?
I'm the CSEC requisitions officer. I need to make sure our buyers are authorized.
This is so why, anyway.
Will you be purchasing anything today, Commander Shepard?
I might need supplies.
Show me what you've got.
Excellent. I hope you find what you're looking for.
I'm not gonna buy anything, I'm just looking. Hydra 2. Should I be buying this stuff, or should I wait? It's a third of our money here. I think I'm gonna wait. Do I need this? I don't understand the deal with the licenses, guys. Sorry. I'll end up getting one, I'm sure, if I need one. I'm sure I will need one. I mean, why is it there? It's a license to buy more stuff. I don't know what it is. It's down here. Hmm. Does this go back up to the same place? Yeah. To the lower wards. CSEC offices. So I'm about to go to lower wards. How about I go to the offices and such first. I guess I go up this elevator to go to that. Oh no. I guess it's upstairs here. I like that theme. Look at this theme. So that's where we are now. Offices, yeah. Well, I can't mess with any of these terminals or talk to any of these people.
Okay, Jahleed. Let me get this straight. Your business partner, sure. He's threatened you?
Well, no. Not exactly. But he wants to meet with me. I think he's going to kill me.
And why do you think that?
I can't really get into the details. But Chorban will kill me if I leave here unprotected.
I can't help you. Not unless you give me something more to go on.
He keeps looking at me.
I can't. I'm sorry.
Then I've got other work to do.
But
nothing. Don't bother me unless you're willing to give me details.
Hmm.
Hey there! Oh, you're not CSEC, are you? Did you want something?
I overheard your conversation.
What were you trying to explain to the officer before?
My colleague is trying to kill me, and I thought we were friends.
Some friends? Kill you, huh?
How do you know he wants you dead?
He's changed. He won't talk to me at work anymore, and he started following me.
Hmm.
Yesterday, he followed me all the way home, just waiting for a chance. I don't care what anyone thinks. He wants me gone. I know it.
Sorry about that, guys. It's so funny. I thought those things hanging down off the... oh my god. I can't stop hitting the mic. I thought those things hanging down were, solid. But he's looking around and they're flapping around. I don't think I've ever seen him look around like that. These guys. What do you need?
Is there something I can do? Talk to your friend, maybe?
Would you? That's all I want. Someone to talk to him. Tell him to leave me alone. He thinks he can just push me around, but you'll show him, won't you?
I'll talk to him.
Just tell me where he is and I'll go find him.
Oh, right. Well, he wanted to meet with me down in the wards near the markets. He said he just wanted to talk, but I know better. His name's Chorban. He's a Salarian. You shouldn't have any trouble. He's just a scientist.
Chorban. That's the guy who wanted us to scam the Keepers.
Oh, very good. I know it sounded familiar.
The Keepers? Well, even more reason to go after him. That's against regulations.
Good point. Although I'm helping him.
I better look into this right away. Find out what he's up to.
Anything's possible with Chorban these days. Well, good luck.
Scan the Keepers. Huh. We've only got 12 out of 21. Hold on 1 second, guys. Sorry about that. I meant to mute that. Hope I'm not killing anyone's ears with this stuff. Pretty pretty.
Hello, Commander.
Well, that's some conversation. Oh, nothing here. And I came from there. Heading up into traffic control. Cool. Well, what's down in there? Is this a spacecraft dock here or something? Tracking terminal. Codex. Oh boy, I got a bunch of stuff. We've already read this. I don't know why this narrator sometimes reads it and sometimes he doesn't. Citadel Security is a volunteer police service answering to the Citadel Council. The 200,000 constables of CSEC are responsible for maintaining public order in the densely populated Citadel. They also provide pirate suppression, customs enforcement, and search and rescue throughout the Citadel cluster. CSEC has 6 divisions. Enforcement. Uniformed officers who patrol the Citadel and respond to emergencies. Investigation. Detectives who puzzle out the truth behind crimes and bring perpetrators to justice. Customs. Screens the thousands of passengers and cargo containers that pass through the Citadel ports every day. Network. Deals with cybercrimes like identity and copyright theft, hacking and viral attacks, and illegal artificial intelligence. Special Response. Deals with hostage situations, bombs, and heavily armed criminals. In the unlikely event that attackers board the Citadel, they are also the front line of defense, armed with military-grade equipment. patrol naval arm with ship stationed throughout the Citadel cluster. Unlike the other divisions, they are rarely seen at the Citadel, nor do they stay in one place long. Joining CSEC is a prestigious... Joining CSEC is prestigious. Applications must be approved by a Citadel counselor or the ambassador of an associate council race. Generally, applicants have many years of distinguished service in the military or police forces of their nation, but an inexperienced applicant with demonstrable talent will be fairly considered. CSEC and the Spectres are often at odds. Many CSEC members, notably current executor Venerae Palin, believe that allowing Spectres to be above the law is a dangerous practice. The actions of Saren Artarius lend credence to this position. The Spectres, in turn, are aggravated when CSEC's dedication to procedure and due process hampers their investigations. Serpent Nebula? The Citadel is surrounded by a blue-tinted reflection nebula. The light of the nebula is actually light from the Citadel scattered and reflected back at the station. Now, you know what's interesting about this image? I'm just going to break here. I actually did go back to the, what we saw, the flashes, when, we touched the beacon. I saw this image. Only it was all red. Of course, everything was red. And I saw people running, looked like they were, being hit by a blast, possibly a nuclear bomb of some kind. And, I saw what looked like a corpse with its head down. It was very hard to see still. But, this is really a prominent image. So, yeah, no spoilers, guys, but it looks like, the Citadel may be under attack or destroyed at some point. So, if it is, do not tell me, please. I'm just, you know, wondering about this stuff. We'll see what happens. Anyway. At first, the Serpent Nebula was assumed to be made of microscopic construction debris. Prevailing theory holds that the Protheans used molecular nanotechnology to manufacture the incredibly durable materials used in the Citadel. But unlike other nebulae, the serpent does not dissipate over time. Therefore, it must be replenished constantly. The current popular theory is that the non-recyclable waste collected by the Citadel's keepers is somehow rendered down to the atomic or molecular level and ejected into the cloud. The thick nebula presents a navigation hazard. Beyond the relatively clear areas around the Citadel, electrical discharges are common. These are not blocked by kinetic barriers and can severely damage metal-framed starships. In addition, some dense knots of dust can overwhelm the repulsion of kinetic barriers on smaller ships. If such a vessel is moving fast enough at the time, the effects are similar to being hit by a sandblaster. Attempting to reach the Citadel through open space navigation is unadvisable. The only safe approach is through the various mass relays that orbit it. The wards. The majority of the Citadel's population lies in the wards, the five massive arms of the station that house the residential and commercial districts. Okay. Oh, I see. So is this where the rapid transit goes around? And where we walk on these bridges? Kinda looks like it would take a lot longer time to walk around. It doesn't seem like it's to scale inside, for lack of a better term. Many galactic races have established cultural enclaves here. Population density and cost of living are extremely high, akin to Earth cities such as Hong Kong and Singapore. The wards are open-topped with skyscrapers rising from the superstructure. Towers are sealed against vacuum, as the breathable atmosphere envelope is only maintained to a height of about 7 meters. Really? So if you go higher than that somehow, you can't breathe, I guess. The atmosphere... Sorry, I'm just imagining this. The atmosphere is contained by the centrifugal force of rotation and a membrane of dense, colorless sulfur hexafluoride gas held in place by carefully managed mass effect fields. The view from the wards is spectacular. In the background, stars, Serpent Nebula, and a nearby blue giant called the Widow moves across the sky as the station rotates to stabilize itself. We're a half hour in. Where was I? In the foreground, the lights of buildings and vehicles on the opposing ward arms perpetually shine. The Citadel has no real day or night. While the station keeps the standard galactic time for political functions, businesses rarely close, and residents acclimate to sleep and work according to personal need rather than a day-night cycle. Additions and modifications are constantly being constructed, though they must stay within certain specifications that will not compromise the operation of the station. Occasionally, the keepers will descend on an area of the wards and move or change the architecture without explanation. Residents have learned to live with these inexplicable intrusions. They will complain about it, though. We've heard that. Citadel and Galactic Government. I guess we've read all this. Citadel Conventions? These diplomatic talks occurred in the wake of the Krogan rebellions as a response to destruction of the conflict and an attempt to distance the Council from the brutal Krogan warfare. The conventions regulate the use of weapons of mass destruction. A WMD causes environmental alteration to a world. A bomb that produces a large crater is not considered a WMD. A bomb that creates a nuclear winter is. I've read this. A dreadnought. The dreadnought is the ultimate arbiter of space warfare. I guess we got this from that console. Millions of tons of metal, ceramic, and polymer dedicated to the projection of firepower against an enemy vessel of like ability. No sane commander would face a dreadnought with anything less than another dreadnought. A dreadnought's power lies in the strength of its main gun. Dreadnoughts range from 800 meters to 1 kilometer long, with a main gun of commensurate length. An 800-meter mass accelerator is capable of accelerating 1.2-kilogram slug to a velocity of 283 kilometers per second every 2 seconds. Each slug has the kinetic energy of 38 kilotons of TNT, three times the energy released by the fission weapon that destroyed Hiroshima. Hiroshima. Well, how do you say that? I've heard it say pronounced both ways, actually. When used to bombard planets, some of this kinetic energy is lost due to an atmospheric reentry friction. As a rule of thumb, each Earth atmosphere of air pressure saps approximately 20% of a projectile's impact energy. The Turian fleet presently has 37 dreadnoughts, the Asari 21, and the Salarian 16. Humanity has 6, with an additional hull under construction at a tourist station. Alliance battleships are named from mountains of Earth. Everest class. Everest, Fuji, and Elbrus. Kilimanjaro class is Kilimanjaro, Taishan, Shasta, and Aconcagua under construction. Technology. Creds. The standard credit was established by the Citadel's Unified Banking Act as the currency of interstellar trade. The credit has a managed floating exchange rate calculated in real time by the central bank to maintain the average value of all participating currencies. Some regional currencies are worth more than a credit and some less. Hard currency can be stolen or counterfeited, so electronic fund transfers are the norm. More importantly, physical transactions cannot be easily tracked, making them ideal for tax evasion or the purchase of illegal goods. When the Alliance joined the Citadel, its various national treasuries were linked into the credit network. A human with a bank account of Mexican pesos, Japanese yen, or Indian rupees can purchase any item priced in credits at fair market value. All economies that participate in the credit network are required to price items in both local currency and credits. I'm not really good with stuff like financial and exchange rate and stuff like that, but How does that really work? I mean, if you're in... I know things are cheaper in Mexico than, you know, in the U.S. Our dollar buys more, you know, is more valuable. So, if we were to walk into Mexico and purchase something with credits, would it be at the same price as if we bought it with American dollars? Or it's... you know, it's equivalent in pesos. That's just say it's beyond the scope of this Let's Play. Tracking terminal. I got more codex crap. And there's more here.